I am Mike Stanton, joined today by BAM's head of Texas underwriting, Greg Pacifico, to talk about the upcoming sale of approximately $80 million of unlimited tax school building bonds by the Sands Consolidated Independent School District in Texas. Greg, what can you tell us about the district?
Thanks, Mike. Sands ISD is located in West Texas in the Permian Basin, so it is a major oil and gas producer. It has a relatively small population and school enrollment, but has a very large property tax base, over $4 billion.
And what about the characteristics of these bonds specifically? What are they secured by?
Sure. So these bonds will be rated AA by S&P based on BAM's guarantee and will also carry an underlying rating of A. The bonds are voter approved and will be repaid with property tax revenues from a dedicated debt service tax levy.
So you brought this transaction to the attention of BAM's underwriting committee. When you were reviewing the credit, what were you looking at?
Yeah, the big question was concentration in economy. Oil and gas is inherently volatile, so property values here are subject to more volatility as compared to some of the other communities that we review. A major mitigant to this is a unique characteristic of the Texas school financing system, under which a property wealthy school district is actually required to make payments back to the state, recapture payments back to the state, which is in turn utilized to support other districts. Sands CISD is a property wealthy district, and therefore a significant portion of their tax collections are utilized to make that recapture payment to the state. So in the event of revenue declines, whether it be oil and gas or other reasons, first impacted would be those recapture payments to the state and would limit the impact on the district's overall operating budget.
And to be clear, that impacts the operating budget of the district, which is separate from the debt service budget, which is backed by a dedicated levy. But as a credit analyst, you're looking at the overall health of the issuer, right?
Absolutely. Yep.
What else should investors be aware of if they're looking at this transaction?
Sure. So this is a relatively rare case of a Texas school district selling with private bond insurance. Typically, a transaction like this would come to market backed by the Texas Permanent School Fund, which is rated AAA. The PSF has reached their capacity. Obviously, that can change in the future. But for the time being, we're going to see issuers like Sands coming to market with bond insurance as they try to attract new investors looking for additional guarantees on their debt.
That was an opportunity for you to work with the municipal advisor and the underwriter on these bonds to make sure that they have the security and the appeal to investors that they need.
Absolutely. Yep.
So ultimately, the strengths BAM's credit committee was looking at, and they voted unanimously to ensure this transaction, were the strong general obligation, unlimited tax pledge that was voter approved, as well as the large property tax base that we discussed that secured these bonds well in excess of the debt service required. Thanks for your time and joining us today, Greg, and thanks everyone for watching. An official statement with complete information on these bonds is available for investors before they invest, as well as a BAM credit profile has also been posted to our website. For more information about BAM or our analysis, please email us at creditinsights@buildamerica.com.